In mold remediation, one of the issues that we deal with is air filtration. And we have a number of really good pieces of equipment that we use for air filtration. This is a HEPA 2000. It cleans 2,000 cubic feet of air per minute. This is a HEPA 500, which cleans 500 cubic feet of air per minute. And depending on the size of the room or the size of the job that we're working on, we choose one or the other. This is a charcoal filter that you can use with this HEPA 500. And it'll actually filter out the air. So if you've got a moldy, musty problem that requires some odor cleaning at the same time, this works really, really well. It's a nice add-on. This is a, and I don't know if you can really tell the difference in color, this is a used one from a job, and this is a new one that hasn't been used yet. So you can tell that this has quite a few more hours on it. One of the things about these HEPA air filtration systems is they're kind of loud and clunky. As you might imagine, having this in your home just for everyday use might not be too comfortable. The other thing is, they're a little loud, and the extra volume kind of makes them uncomfortable to have in a house. However, you can go back to Lowe's or Home Depot, and a company named Idylis, I-D-Y-L-I-S, makes a beautiful in-home air filtration system. HEPA stands for High Efficiency Particulate Air. In other words, it filters out 99.97% of all the stuff in the air. So basically, it takes most of the mold spores out. Now, some of those are a little bit smaller, and so what you want to have for that is UV light. They accomplish a couple of things. One is they clean the air, and they also have UV light, so they kill any mold spores that are in there. On top of that, they add some nice white noise. So if you live near a place where there's a lot of traffic sounds, it'll mask over those sounds. It also, the Idylis unit that I'm a real big fan of is about $250. Sometimes they're on sale for a little bit less. But the nice thing about those is they also have an auto setting. So they speed up and slow down. They clean more air or less air depending on how dirty they detect the air is. I have two of them in my own home, and usually whoever's sick that day, if somebody's got a cold or something like that, the air filtration system goes in their room. Again, it adds them a nice white noise, plus they'll get a good 6 to 8 hours of good sleeping air. They'll get good air to sleep with at night, and so usually that'll make the cold go away. One of the early detectors of having mold in your home is having somebody in your house that has cold and flu-like symptoms that just won't seem to go away. You'll notice that in the day, you go off to school or go off to work, and you start feeling better. And then you come home in the evening and those symptoms start coming back again. That's usually a pretty good sign that you've got mold in your home. And a really, really good way to tell if that's exactly what it is get one of these Idylis HEPA air filtration systems for your home, park it right next to your bed and turn it on, and then sleep with it at night. And if you notice your symptoms tend to go away, then it's probably dirty air that you're breathing. Now, in my kids' school, they get what I call kennel cough. Basically, the kids go to school, you got a classroom of 30 or 40 kids. One kid sneezes, that sneeze and stuff goes into the air, and then all the other kids breathe it, they all get sick, and then they bring it home to me, and I pass it on to my wife, and we pass it around the house a couple of times. Last year, I took these HEPA air filtration systems and put them in my kids' classroom, and they didn't bring a cold home once. So I highly recommend these systems. Make sure that they say HEPA and that they have a UV light to kill mold spores. Put them in your kids' room. Make sure you've got a sizable one, a big enough one for the room that you're putting it in. And either put it in one of two places. Either put it next to your bed where you're going to be sleeping, or put it next to where you think the mold problem might be. The real problem that mold affects us is that it's in the air that we breathe. And if it goes into the air we breathe, then it goes into our lungs, then it causes the health problems. If you can take it out of the air, in other words, the air that you're breathing is clean and free of mold, then you won't have these signs and symptoms. And then even if you have a house which is kind of a little older, has had a lot of water damage over the years, it's not a good substitute for remediation. If you've got mold, you should probably get it remediated, but it's a way you can make it manageable in the meantime. If you've got to live in the house, maybe you've got friends coming over the holidays, or you're going to be out of town and you can't do it, at least put something into the house to clean the air while you're there, so that you can have nice, clean, breathable air until you have the time and the money to go ahead and get the mold remediated.